Reviving the history of young minds' curiosity. Reliving the seeds of the 1880s, the period when tobacco cigars became the most acclaimed industry among the oldest cigar companies in the world. Antonio Lopez y Lopez, the sobriquet of the great Tabacalera Incorporator. Lopez, being the first Marques de Comillas, was one of the sole founders who formed the Compañía General de Tobacos de Filipinas. It was a private enterprise he founded with the sole intention of taking over the Philippine tobacco monopoly from the Spanish colonial government.
He was a financial prodigy during his time, and his clout stretched to the Spanish king, whom he considered a personal friend. His tobacco company absorbed the colonial government's existing tobacco monopoly.
He was able to successfully maintain 5 tobacco plants, in which one of the company's plants is in Lalo, Cagayan, which was formerly known as Ciudad de Nueva Segovia. The industry played a valuable part in the economic development of not only the Lopez family, but also Cagayan and the Spanish Empire.
The remnants of Tabacalera of the Compañía General de Tabacos was located in Barangay Sanase, historically known as Sigiran. The land where the Tabacalera ruins now stand was once home to numerous other historic monuments, including the Catedral de San Pedro, Cota de San Francisco, and Casa Real, which were all demolished during World War II and later turned into residential slums.
After the provincial administration moved from Lalo to Tuguegarao in 1839, the Casa Real compound ceased functioning. In the 1850s, it was turned into an administrative building and warehouses for the Compañía General de Tabacos, or known as the Tabacalera. From 1782 to 1882, Cagayan was ruled by the tobacco monopoly. The Tabacalera would continue to function until the onset of World War II. The Japanese turned it into a garrison, and it was attacked in 1945. The Tabacalera was abandoned.
The Tabacalera slot was the hollowed-out ground on which Bishop Benavides previously walked and managed his diocese. The Tabacalera ruins are a witness to Lalo's growth throughout the Spanish era. The cathedrals and the cottages' remains may no longer be visible, but the storytelling will bring them back to life in Lalo Kenya's mind.
We interviewed with several of the people of Barangay San Jose and Centro who live close to the Tabacalera ruins about their recollections, heard rumors, and experiences in Tabacalera.
Ano pong alam niyo tungkol sa Tabacalera?
Ang ano ko lang po, bahay daw ito ng ano, prinsesa.
May tawag po ba kayo dito sa Tabacalera sa dialect mo po?
Wala naman po. Eh, ang ano namin, eh, compound lang, eh, compound dito. Tabacalera compound ang tawag namin dito.
Naabutan niyo po ba yung mga kaganapan sa Tabacalera noon?
Okay, anak. Naabutan ko. And that was when I was in the elementary grades.
Ano pong alam niyo tungkol sa Tabacalera?
Okay. I know during the olden times, Tabacalera was the center of trade and industry in Lalo. Because Tabacalera then was the seat of business. And it was during the time when I was in elementary, because I was born in 1956, and so I was in grade 2. I remember it right when the Spaniards landed in the riverbank, and they brought with us goods just like garlic. Yes, garlic. And there was a exchange of goods. And I remember it right.
May mga experience po ba kayong na-encounter noon?
Ah, yes, of course. There was a time na we celebrated the Fiesta of Lalo, Ana. And Ferdinand Marcos attended the Fiesta of Lalo. And the celebration was right there in Dita Bacalera. Yes.
Ano po sa tingin nyo ang naging tulong ng Tabacalera sa mga Lalokinos noon?
Of course, the business was then all about barter, no? Barter yan. So, the Spaniards got married with the Lalokinos. And that is the very reason why Lalokinos, especially the ladies, were very beautiful because it was a breed. It was a breed, I should say, between the Lalokinos and the Spaniards. Yes.
Huling tanong po, ano pong pagbabago ang napansin niyo sa Tabacalera?
Ang pagbabago sa Tabacalera is that it is highly developed now. And anak, I have a house there, no? And there are erected business also there, just like stores, shell crafts, wood crafts, and residents of Tabacalera are, if I say 60% professionals.
Ano po yung mga pagbabago na napansin mo po sa Tabacalera?
How many years passed? Nung pumasok na ang mga fabrika dyan, totally they built all their houses, wala na yung mga ruins na, wala na. Pero still, it is still there, kaya lang, siyempre yung mga bahay-bahay yan, bahay-bahay na, nandun na. Pero meron pa naiwan na isang malaking balon, nandun pa lang kung gusto nyo tingnan.
Ay, malaki ang Tabacalera ng araw kasi it was an old-fashioned manufacturing yan. Kung baga sa ano, kung hindi pa sila kumpleto ng mga machineries, iba yung teknolohiya nila kaysa ngayon. Ang ngayon, ang Tabacalera kasi, before, ito at gaya ng sabi ko, their main product is about tobacco, from tobacco. Then may mga wine sila, na product. Pero ngayon, yung pagkaiba ngayon, it is mainly cigarette, manufacturing of cigarettes. Parang at Tabacalera na wala na. Nung nag-introduce na yung mga advanced technology, manufacturing ng introduction of cigarettes, parang unti-unti na na-phase out. At saka yung Tabacalera, nung araw po, tabako ginagamit ng mga tao. At nung pumasok na yung new technology for the production of tobaccos, naging cigarettes, sigarilya na yung gamit.
We also arrange a virtual session with the historian, researcher, and the vice president of Cagayan Heritage Conservation History. Watch as he shared with us his knowledge and recollections about the history of Tabacalera in our town.
My question po is, ano-ano po mga kaganapan lang nangyari sa Tabacalera dati?
Lalo, oh yeah. Maraming nangyari, hindi na-record yung iba, yan, unfortunately. Kasi yung mga records nun, either na sa Manila nasira nung gera, or kung safe man, na-store man siya sa Spain at saka sa yan, National Archives, Manila. Pero yung mga nangyari dyan sa Tabacalera nun, first of all, ang Cagayan was under tobacco monopoly for almost a century, or centuries na lang sabihin natin. Kasi taniman tayo ng tabako nun eh. In fact, ang tabako ng Cagayan nun nakakaabot pa hanggang mapanoon hanggang Europe, US. Yung Tabacalera, it used to be, yung nga sinabi ko nung unay, kasarian noon. Then yung office ng Alcalde Mayor, which is the governor, provincial governor. Maraming nangyari, first of all, yung 1718 revolt. Kasi nandun yung fort noon eh. Nilusob ng mga rebels noon from Tuguegarao, tsaka from Tuao. Unfortunately, yung nangyari, yung rebels from Tuguegarao, napaalis sila eh, successfully. Pero yung mga taga-Tuao, it took time bago sila na-retain ng mga Espanyol. Pero yung regarding doon sa Fort of Lalo, yung San Francisco, one of our researchers has been doing a comprehensive research on the fort of Cagayan. Hopefully it could help.
Okay. Ito po yung pangalawang tanong ko. Okay. Sa tingin nyo po ba ay maaari pang ma-reconstruct o ma-preserve yung mga remains ng Tabacalera? Considering po na may mga residential lots na po.
Yan yung mga issues natin na heritage conservation. Kung may floor plan siya, you could rebuild. Unfortunately, mala nag-pop, nag-resurface na ano, floor plan. So, ang pinaka-safety rehabilitation. Pwedeng reconstruct kasi makita mo, parang may staircase pa nga siya eh. Doon sa isang kwan, kita ko pa yun eh. At saka kung residential, that's a delicate issue. Kasi kwan yan eh, the bounce of law kasi talagang lalaban yung legal tsaka yung heritage dyan eh.
Third question. Bilang isang historian po, ano po yung nalalaman yung purpose or kahalagahan maliban po sa pagiging kumpanya na po ito ng tabako or pagawaan ng tabako? Ano po yung nalalaman ninyong gawa? I mean, purpose po nito maliban po sa pagiging company ng tabako po, yung Tabacalera.
Okay. Yung Tabacalera, yeah, I already said, yan yung kasari. It is to be the residence and the office of the governor of Cagayan, yung Alcaldemayor until 1841. Then, ano yung add sa Tabacalera? It was the office of the Compañía General de Tabac. Mahaba yung pangalan nun. Yan yung offices eh. In fact, yung mga warehouses, doon sa mga bahay-bahay na yun, may mga warehouse ang Tabacalera dyan noon. Take one yan nun eh. It was a lucrative business during and after the Tobacco Monopoly. Kahit noong 1900s, nagpa-function pa yan. At noong World War II, naging kampo pa ng Hapon yan. Office ng mga sundanong Hapon yan noon. Kaya medyo may gruesome story din yung Tabacalera. Hindi nga, binomba. And after that, si Teresa Dupaya was the only lady governor of Cagayan. Ginawa niyang exhibit yan, yung area na yan. Exhibit ng Cagayan yana.
Hi po.
Hello, good morning.
Ano po yung mga yung mga pagbabago po na nung Tabacalera noon po sa at sa ngayon?
Changes, okay. You will notice eh, provinces na siya ngayon. Pero in its heydays, yung glory days niya. Tsaka yan yung warehouses, yung offices ng Tabacalera. So right now, yung mga changes ngayon, yung mga bahay nga. Talagang pinamahayan na yung part ng ruins.
Years passed. Tabacalera is almost unrecognizable with the homes that now litter around the structure. Time and decay have been kind to the Tabacalera, but not so with humans. What time and decay spared for posterity we have in our cultural amnesia, or perhaps ignorance or merely unconcern, have destroyed.
Time and decay then is not the enemy of heritage. Even ancient ruins develop their charm and allure with the passing of time. What could have been a historically significant learning experience? A bustling arts, cultural hotspot, or even a place for events has now fallen.
Thank you.